Hello again, it's Tim Spector here of the Zoe Symptom Study app, giving you this week's update, which is optimistic, I think. We're down to 8,000, just over 8,000 new cases a day, which has changed from last week where we were in a bit of a plateau, things weren't moving and I was a bit more depressed. So things have started to come down now and we're down to about 120,000 symptomatic cases across the country, which means you've got about one in 480 chance of bumping into someone with COVID, which is improving all the time. Now, the other data we're looking at show that there are differences between the regions emerging. So it looks like the south of England is decreasing further than the Midlands and the north of England, and we may end up in a similar situation to where we were earlier in the year with this slight disparity. But I'm still really confident that we're overall, these rates are great because we're nearly down to 10% of where we were at the height of this problem at the beginning of January. So well done everyone for that. Now, we're just talking about new cases here, but let's not forget the bigger picture. And our reports do tell us how full the number of our hospitals are with COVID patients. And at the moment, that's between 5 and 14% and going down. Number admissions across the country are about 1,100 and going down. And we're also seeing the number of deaths reducing steadily each week, which was the main criteria for the government and the particular choice of who to vaccinate. And they're down to about 340 cases a day, which, although still sounds a lot, is small compared to the number of people dying of other causes, which is well over about 1,200 people for this time of year. So that's all good news. And if you combine that with our vaccine data, where over 650,000 of you have now logged your vaccines, we're seeing still very low rates of side effects and lower than in the trials. So generally you've got less than a 1 in 5 chance of having any systemic problems. So most people are absolutely fine. And this is generally only lasting a couple of days in most people. Have to be a bit careful if you've had COVID before, you're more likely to have a more powerful reaction, more likely, but also if you're younger or female, but generally it's looking really good for most people, so nothing to worry about. So if we combine this, I think we're in a state where we're going to see these rates continue to drop. I suspect they will start to flatten out in many parts of the country, as we saw last summer. We never got below about 2,000 cases a day, and I don't think we're going to get much below that either. And partly that's because of the number of tests we're doing, which, although they're brilliant and have over 99.7% specificity, you will pick up a reasonable number of false positives when rates are really low. So that's something to think about, particularly when kids are going back to school and they have a positive test. Always get another one before you believe it. Now, I think with all this good news, we should be start thinking about, can we relax some of these, this roadmap a bit earlier? Let's have a look next week. And if it's still going that way, I think we definitely should be pushing for that. Thanks you for support. Do keep logging. If you've had a vaccine, we want to know about your symptoms and whether you have any symptoms of COVID or not. So keep taking those tests. Thank you for your support.